Welcome to Yesu Mofra Danfo. It's a great and exciting channel.
Hello guys, welcome to Yesu Mofra Danfo. I'm Auntie Arajua, and it's always such a great delight to be in your homes or wherever you find yourselves. I trust your week has been great. I have been blessed. I am well by the grace of God. Well, in today's lesson, as the Israelites continue their journey to the promised land, God did another great miracle, like the parting of the Red Sea. Do you want to know more? Stay tuned, guys. We'll be right back after the song.
Our memory verse for this month, Deuteronomy chapter 1 verse 29. Then I said to you, do not be terrified, do not be afraid of them. Amen. Now in the Ghanaian language, Asante Chi. Mose woma etosunu, terbaku, inchichemu adionunku. Na mese mose, mumma makumentu, na munsrowo. Amen.
Guys, in today's lesson, the Israelites are finally getting closer and closer to the promised land. Get your super books ready, get your Bibles ready, and let's delve deeper into today's Bible story. Our Bible story for today is titled, The Promised Land. crossing the Jordan River. Now, I'm going to give you some fun facts about the Jordan River. Our scripture text is taken from the book of Joshua that follows immediately after the book of Deuteronomy, the sixth book of the Bible, Joshua chapter 1, verse 6 to 9, chapter 3, verse 15 to 19, chapter 4, verse 4 to 9, and verse 17 and 18. Interesting. Let's have our Bible story for today.
Lessons from our Bible story. In our previous lesson, the wilderness, Joshua and Caleb. 12 spies were sent out to check out the promised land. 10 out of these 12 brought about a bad report and did not trust God enough to fight them. But Joshua and Caleb did. They trusted God enough even though they were afraid and believed God to fight for them and give them victory to possess the land. So guys, no matter the challenges we face, big, small, large, huge, tall, difficult or easy, our God will always fight for us. We just need to trust Him. In today's lesson, the Promised Land, crossing the Jordan River. Fun facts about the Ark of Covenant and the Jordan River. The Ark of Covenant is also known as the Ark of Testimony. The Ark contains battered Aaron's rod, a bowl of manna, and the commandment. It is made of acacia wood and coated in pure gold. It has a lid, which is called the mercy seat, with two cherubs with open wings. It weighs about 131 kilograms. And finally, Moses built this ark by God's instructions with two craftsmen, Bezalel and Aholiab. Now the Jordan River. The Jordan River in the Middle East is one of the lowest rivers in the world. It ends in the Dead Sea at a depth of 400 meters below sea level. It is more than 360 kilometers long. Jordan is considered one of the holy rivers in the world. Jesus was baptized in this river. And finally, it is known by three different names depending on the country it flows through. Guys, Moses, after leading the Israelites for 40 years, was led by God to the land of Moab on the mountain of Nebo and died there at the age of 120 years. Wow! Full of strength, and his eyes were not dim. He could see at that age even without glasses, and God himself buried him, and no man except God knew where he was buried. Guys, as the Lord preserved Moses and lived for so many years full of vitality and good health, and he could climb mountains at that age, may the Lord cause each and every one of you watching me right now to live a long life full of health and vitality, and may every sickness and weakness or diseases be far from you and your families in Jesus' name. Guys, before Moses died, God chose a leader for Israel. Can you guess who that was? Joshua, son of Nun, from last week's lesson. Moses laid hands on him and prayed for him to lead the Israelites to the promised land. As Moses was never able to step foot in that land. Why? Because he disobeyed God. God showed him the promised land on a mountain. He only saw with his naked eyes the promised land as a punishment from God for disobeying him some time back. Instead of speaking to the rock for the waters to come out at Meribah Kadesh when the Israelites were thirsty, he rather struck the rock two times, disobeying God's word. That, guys, obedience is very important to God. Sometimes we may say, oh, it's just this and it's just that, but to God it is very important. He takes obedience very seriously. And so because of disobedience, Moses missed the promised land. Guys, God commanded the new leader of Israel, Joshua, to lead the Israelites to cross the river Jordan to the promised land. God assured Joshua he was with him, and he told him to be strong and of good courage, as he would bless them with all the lands he had promised their forefathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. They just had to read the laws he had given them and do everything written in them and meditate. What is meditate? to reflect and think deeply about all the laws and instructions he had given them, and with that they will be more than victorious. Guys, they set off on their journey to cross the river. The priest carried the Ark of the Covenant and stood in the middle of the river as the Lord had commanded Joshua. Remember, it's a river. It's flooded and it's deep and it's flowing with so much force. But they obey the instructions of God. Immediately the priest held the Ark of Covenant and stood in the middle of the Jordan. It became dry ground and parted. Amazing. Similar to the parting of the Red Sea. The priest stood in the middle until the whole assembly of Israel had crossed. And after crossing, Joshua asked 12 leaders from each tribe to go to the dry ground of the Jordan and pick up stones onto their shoulders to serve as a memorial to the Israelites forever. Guys, this way, the Israelites will always remember this great miracle the Lord did for them. So remembering what God has done, what God is doing, is very important to God. We should be able to write all the good things that the Lord has done for us in order not to forget. And these will serve as testimonies we can share with others. And it also helps us to thank God for his goodness. It is a sin to forget. Now Joshua finally commanded the priests to come out of the Jordan. And they did, carrying the Ark of Covenant. And immediately they moved out. The waters of the Jordan returned to their place and ran in a flood as before. Guys, there's something beautiful here. The priest held the ark, which is made of acacia wood and coated in pure gold, for hours for all of Israel to cross, but didn't complain or murmur that is too heavy, my hands are tired, my hands are hurting. They did it joyfully. Whatever work you're given to do, do it with so much joy in your heart without complaining, and God will bless you. Finally, guys, the Israelites in their journey to the promised land always camped and lived in tents. They knew wherever they camped was not their final home, the promised land. They knew God had prepared a land flowing with milk and honey. In the same way, you and I are in this world, on this earth. This is not our permanent home. We are not from here. We are just camping, waiting for the beautiful place that God is preparing for us. So we need to have that in mind. We need to have that consciousness that one day we'll live this earth to live eternity with God, our Maker, our Jehovah Jireh, our El Shaddai, Almighty God. Hallelujah.
Guys, have you spoken to Jesus? Remember that Jesus lives in your heart. He's at all places at the same time. And in times like this is the time we need to be talking to him every single day, in the morning, in the afternoon, and in the evening. Shall we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this morning. We thank you for your word that has come to us, that you make Joshua brave and courageous to take your people to the promised land. We pray and ask that in times like this, oh God, give us the strength, give us the courage to be brave like Joshua was and took the Israelites to the promised land. Help us not to be afraid, like our memory verse says. We know you are with us. We thank you that you are a great provider. We thank you that you are our protector. We give you all the glory. We thank you for an answered prayer. We thank you that you are Jehovah Jireh. We thank you that you are El Shaddai. We thank you that you are God and you are unchangeable. As you were with Joshua, you will always be with us. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Guys, welcome back. So I'm going to sing this song in our local Ghanaian language, Asantiri, which simply talks about the beautiful city, the New Jerusalem, that I talk about every Saturday. Now it goes like this. Jesus is yes, it's not biawo soro, o di si kani jas papo, o be ba braye ninda ho, o be fa na ho te fo yina ko, na ye be ko ho, hallelujah. Na ye be ko ho, hallelujah. Na ye be ko ho, hallelujah, hallelujah, na ye be ko ho. So Jesus is preparing that beautiful place for you and I. And I will be there, as always. And when I'm there, I am going to look for you. So guys, let us live in that consciousness that we are not from here like the Israelites. They had a promised land and we also have a promised land. Guys, I hope you enjoyed today's lesson and you learned something new. God bless you so much for tuning in today. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Down in my heart. Where?
Connect with us on Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more views. Thank you for watching. God bless you. Yes, my friend, downfall.